ഹലോ മൈ ഡിയർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്, വെൽക്കം ടു ദ ഫോർത്ത് എപ്പിസോഡ് ഓഫ് ദ പ്ലേ ലിസൺ ടു ദ മൗണ്ടൻ. ഹൗ ആർ യു ഓൾ? ഫൈൻ, ദറ്റ്സ് നൈസ്. സ്റ്റേയിങ് അറ്റ് ഹോം വിത്ത് യുവർ ഡിയർ ആൻഡ് നിയർ വൺസ്. സോ വി ഹാവ് ബീൻ ലേണിംഗ് ദ ലെസൺ ലിസൺ ടു ദ മൗണ്ടൻ, എ പ്ലേ റിട്ടൺ ബൈ കാവേരി നമ്പീശൻ. Do you remember the events that happened in the first three scenes? Yes? Okay. Sagar and Dikshit have arrived at the village with a plan of building a five-star hotel on the top of Dharmagiri mountain. The villagers didn't like the plan of the construction of a five-star hotel in the village of Dharmagiri. So they decide to raise their voice against this issue. Have you done all the assignments I gave you in the previous class? Yes? All of you? Very nice. What is the first assignment I gave you? Yes? To prepare the probable conversation between the villagers and Sagar. Did you all write it? Yes? That's nice. Here is a creative work prepared in the form of an animation by one of my students. Here it is.
Hello. Who all are these? Welcome, welcome.
Thank you, Sagar.
Why have you all come together? Is there anything serious to discuss?
Yes, of course. You see, Sagar, we are here to request you to reconsider the decision of building a five-star hotel on the top of the Dharmagiri mountain.
What nonsense are you talking about?
No, it is not nonsense. We have discussed this matter among us, and nobody wants such huge hotel here.
Sagar, please be sensible. The beauty and serenity of our whole village is going to be ruined. Our land is going to be filthy. Our rivers, the waterfalls, the trees, and the wildlife, everything is going to be destroyed.
This is tourism, my dear fellows, tourism. Money is going to pour into this land. Only Kannan has some sense.
The villagers are very contented with what we have. They like my tea, my coffee, my doshas and idlis. They don't want anything more than that.
There is something more serious than all this. You see that temple on the top of the hill? It was built some 300 years ago. When they built that temple, they had realized that the earth there could not hold a structure taller than 30 feet.
Ha ha ha, that's quite funny. You village bumpkins know more than the engineers and architects from the big cities. It's the project of Mr. Dikshit. If he has wished something, he will definitely make it. The work will start tomorrow. You can go home. Bye.
Did you watch the animation? Yes. You like it? Very good. You can also think of such creative works in the form of animation or short movies, in any form. It's up to you. In this animation video, you just saw that Sagar has decided to continue with the work. Do you support Sagar's decision of making a hotel in Dharmagiri? No. We cannot support Sagar's decision of making a multi-story hotel in Dharmagiri. Dharmagiri is so beautiful. The mountains, the rivers, the plants, the birds, everything is going to be destroyed very soon. Do you think the things in nature, like mountains, rivers, trees, birds, they all can speak? Yes, if we listen to them, right? Okay, here is a video. Let's watch it. Did you enjoy the video? Yes? Very good. So, the things in the nature can speak in a language we can understand if we really listen to them. Okay. Now, do you want to know what happened then? Yes? Okay, we will move on to the next scene. Scene number 4. Did you listen to the conversation between our characters? Yes? You like it? Very good. Who are the characters you come across in this scene? Who can say? Yes, two characters. Narayan and grandmother. Narayan and grandmother are the only characters who appear in this scene. How does the grandmother feel? Who can say? Yes, that's it. She feels very sad. She thinks that the beauty of the village is going to be destroyed forever. Now, what is the suggestion given by the grandmother? Can anyone say? Yes, she tells Narayan to discuss the matter with the students of the school. Very good. Now, my dears, it's time for you to read the text. Remember, while reading the text, note down all the difficult words. Ready? Read the text.
Grandmother hobbles on the stage with Narayan and stands in front of the curtain.
Tell me what happened.
The villagers don't want the hotel. We went to Mr. Sagar and explained that not only would our village be ruined, but the mountain itself was in danger. They cannot dig a deep foundation on it.
What did Sagar say?
He was annoyed. Do you village bumpkins know more than the engineers and architects from the big cities? He asked. They are starting work tomorrow.
Where will they go? The rabbits, the deer and the partridge. Who will listen to their plight? Who will listen to our river, our clean, beautiful, sweet-watered river that will now turn foul with filth?
And who will listen to the sorrow of Dharmagiri when it is massacred by roads and burned with buildings? The noise, the pollution, oh, you think I am crazy because I care of these things, because I can hear their voice. Don't believe me if you don't want to, but I know. The mountains, the rivers, the trees and the animals, they all speak just like you and say, you and me. If only we listen to them. But the world now is so full of noise. How can anyone hear the softly gurgling stream or the breeze as it rustles through the leaves or the flutter of birds' wings?
Navaji, don't get upset.
I know. What has the hotel got to do with me? You know something. This has more to do with the children of our village than anyone else. Tomorrow's world is their world. You are the school headmaster. You must talk to the children. Find out what they feel about it. Don't put ideas into their heads. Just tell them everything and let them think for themselves.
They go off stage through left and re-enter from right.
What did the children have to say?
They don't want a hotel on Dharmagiri if it will ruin our countryside.
I thought so. Children are wise. It is still not too late. We must take a stand, or else big people with small hearts will swallow this beautiful village of ours.
Mr. Dixit is arriving tomorrow. They will start laying the foundation. We will stage a peaceful protest and submit a petition.
Good luck, son. Good luck.
They move off stage.
Have you finished reading? All of you? Very good. Now, did you come across any unfamiliar words while reading? Yes? Which word? Village bumpkin. Okay. Watch this video.
ഞാള് ചൂലുമ്പിള്ളായി നിൽക്കുന്ന നേരം നോക്കി തമ്പ്രാട്ടി എന്തിനാണ് എണീറ്റ് വരുന്നത്?
ഇങ്ങനൊരു മരത്തലേനെ ഞാൻ ജീവിതത്തിൽ കണ്ടിട്ടില്ല. നശൂല. നീ എപ്പോഴാ ചന്തേന്ന് വന്നേ?
ഞാള് പൊലച്ചൊക്കെ വന്നേ.
ഓ, മറ്റേ രണ്ടെണ്ണം എവിടെ?
തമ്പ്രാനും മാണിക്കനും പിന്നാലെ വരുന്നുണ്ട്. ചന്തയില് ചരക്കറക്കെട്ടി കാളിനെയും കുളിപ്പിച്ച് ബണ്ടി കൊണ്ട് പോന്നോളാ ഞാളോട് പറഞ്ഞേ.
മൂക്കറ്റം കേട്ടിട്ടായിരിക്കും തമ്പ്രാന്റെ വരവ്.
അത് ഞാക്കറിയില്ല തമ്പ്രാട്ടി. തമ്പ്രാൻ കള്ളുപുരയെ കയറി പോണത് ഞാള് കണ്ടിട്ടില്ല.
പിന്നെ നീ എന്തോ കണ്ടു?
കള്ളുപുരയിൽ നിന്ന് ഇറങ്ങി വരുന്നത് കണ്ട്.
Here you see a village bumpkin. Village bumpkins are not very intelligent, ordinary persons. Malayalathil parayam naattum purathukaran. Okay? Yes. Is there any other word? Yes. Patriots. Okay. Look at this picture. This is a picture of a patriot. It's a medium sized bird. It's clear? Okay. Is there any other word? Yes. Which one? Okay, massacre. Look at this picture. This is a famous painting. This painting is based on the Jallianwalabagh massacre. This incident resulted in the death of more than 1,000 people, killing people in large numbers is known as massacre. Kootakola, Kootakurudi, idakkeyana മാസക്കർ എന്ന വേർഡ് കൊണ്ട് ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത്. ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ഡു യു വോണ്ട് ടു ഗോ ടു ദ വില്ലേജ് ഓഫ് ധർമ്മഗിരി? യെസ്. ടു ലിസൺ ടു ദ വേർഡ്സ് ഓഫ് അവർ ഗ്രാൻഡ് മദർ, ലെറ്റ്സ് ഗോ.
വേർ വിൽ ദേ ഗോ? ദ റാബിറ്റ്സ്, ദ ഡീർ ആൻഡ് ദ പാട്രിഡ്ജ്. ഹു വിൽ ലിസൺ ടു ദിയർ പ്ലൈറ്റ്? Who will listen to our river, our clean, beautiful, sweet-watered river that will now turn foul with filth? And who will listen to the sorrow of Dharmagiri when it is massacred by roads and burdened with buildings? The noise, the pollution. Oh, you think I am crazy because I care for these things. Because I can hear their voices. Don't believe me. If you don't want to, but I know the mountains, the rivers, the trees, and animals, they speak just like you and me. If only we listen to them. But now the world is so full of noise. How can anyone hear the softly gurgling stream or the breeze as it rustles through the leaves, or the flutter of a bird's wings?
Did you listen to the words of our grandmother? The poor old mother is very sad and depressed. She thinks of the beautiful village, the rabbits, the deer, and all the other things in the village. How was the performance of the grandmother? You liked it? Yes? Wasn't it really impressive? Of course. There are many scenes in this play which you can also perform. You can also think of doing that. Don't you feel like supporting the views of the grandmother? Yes, she is right in her opinion. Don't you also share the same views? What is the cause of grandmother's sorrow? The grandmother is worried about the deer, the rabbits, the partridge, and how the clean and sweet watered river will turn foul with the filth. She also thinks that the Dharmagiri mountain is going to be burdened with buildings. How does the grandmother remind her grandson about his duties? Yes, the grandmother says, tomorrow's world is children's. And her grandson, being the headmaster, must talk to the children about the dangers the village is going to face. Did you notice the expression, big people with small hearts? Yes, can you comment on it? The grandmother mocks at the rich people of the new generation by this comment. She complains about their selfish, money-minded attitude. Do you remember the instructions given by the grandmother to the headmaster? Yes. The first instruction, you must talk to the children. Then, find out what they feel about it. Don't put ideas into their heads. Just tell them everything. These instructions can be converted into requests. Can you try? Yes, the first one. The first sentence, you must talk to the children. It can be converted like this. Could you please talk to the children? Would you mind talking to the children? What about the other sentences? Can you convert these instructions into requests in the same way? Will you do it? Yes, I know, you will definitely do it. Write it in your notebook as an assignment. Send it to your teacher also. Ready? Okay. It's time for me to wind up. I am Sunish P. Joss from IJM Higher Secondary School, Kottayur. Goodbye.